What is a robot? That's a great question.
A robot is a thing that senses, plans, and acts.
My definition of robot is a device that has been created to automate tasks that humans should not be asked to do.
I would say a robot has the capacity to react to you physically as well as digitally.
A robot used to be a clunky little metallic structure back in the 50s movies.
There's a lot of fears about robots, and many of it probably does come from sci-fi. We tend to have the Terminator and HAL. They always take over the world and kill all the humans, and that's sort of a trope. It's getting old, like it's time for us to have new stories.
The robot we're building is what is called a socially assistive robot, and it's built using the idea that people fidget with different sorts of things to help themselves regulate how they feel. And you can see this in everyday like stress balls. Interestingly, there's not a ton of data about when and how these things help. So my group has been doing studies, working with collaboration partners to really get to the bottom of that. So it's essentially a way for kids to practice soothing themselves by soothing this other little creature, this little socially assistive robot. And by going through that feedback loop, they end up practicing calming themselves. That's the premise of the project.
I really believe that we are at the tipping point in which understanding how the brain works, for example, and how robots are going to be built in different ways than in the past. The goal is to create a very light suit, which is wearable and can actually not even be noticed, eventually can be worn under clothes, and can very mildly help or augment the movement of different parts of the body. Helping people with disabilities or which recently had a stroke or other problems to regain their motion. The inspiration for the suit comes from nature itself. We are trying to recreate emotion which is very similar with the human body. However, our students, being Santa Cruz students, at the end of the day, for now, we have a glorified wetsuit which has bicycle components on it to make it move.
My research is about developing computer systems and games with and for people with special needs. One game that we have is for physical rehabilitation for stroke survivors and people recovering from upper limb injuries. The game has motion capture. In the game, you are supposed to use your weak sight to catch stars in a cosmic galaxy. And if you use your weak sight to catch that star, you're going to get points as well as beautiful soundtrack. If you use your strong sight to do the same task, you're going to get very little point and the soundtrack is not as nice. And the idea is that to encourage people to use their weak sight.
I think the way that I think about ethics is really whose ethics are they? Many times it comes back to what brings them dignity. And are you taking it away? Are you helping them and enabling them in some way?
You can do great things with technology and you can do kind of scary things with technology, but I think we have a lot of really interesting things happening in the field of robotics that I think are super for everyday life.